What's good, everyone? Thank you for stopping by to visit the channel for this upcoming playoff semifinal preview. If you want to stay updated in the world of college football, if you haven't done so already, click that subscribe button, click the notification bell, and select all so you won't miss another video. Our first stop is in Atlanta, Georgia for the Peach Bowl semifinal matchup between the number one ranked LSU Tigers and the number four Oklahoma Sooners for a shot to play for the national championship in Nowlands, Louisiana. If you are a longtime follower of the channel, I always start off with the tail of the tape between the two teams. But since we have over 12 games of data, let's take a look at the respective resumes. This is an impressive resume. They have 5 wins against F+ top 25 teams and 7 among the top 50. Based off of LSU's opponent F+ ranking, it is the best of the playoff participants with Ohio State nipping at their heels. It is tied for first for the best opponent offensive S&P Plus rating and second in opponent defensive SP Plus average. The Tigers face 7 teams ranked in the top 50 in opponent SP Plus, with 5 ranked in the top 25 and 6 teams ranked in the top 50 in defensive SP Plus, with 4 of them ranked in the top 25. This is a battle-tested team that seemed to have gotten better since week 1. No shock to see Alabama's offense as a closest comparison to the Sooners on LSU's schedule. In fact, the Crimson Tide are either one spot below or ahead of the Sooners in their respective metrics. The Tiger defense did slow down Alabama in the first half, but in the second half, the Crimson Tide went nuts, ending up with 418 yards passing and a rush for 123 yards at 7.96 yards per play in that game. Now, when you see Alabama's rush defense and pass defense, that should be a good sign if you are an LSU fan. The Tigers had tremendous success on the ground and through the air against Alabama in that game. The Sooner resume is not bad at all. It is third behind Ohio State and LSU in overall F+ rating, and it is tied with LSU for the best overall opponent offensive SP+ rating. Their only loss was against 37-3 in Kansas State, and that is a game the Sooner fans want to forget. The Sooners had more wins this year against the F+ top 25 than they did a year ago, so I do believe the Sooners are a better team than they were a year ago, especially on the defensive end, as the Sooners are currently ranked 18th in total defense against FBS competition. It is tough to find comparisons here for LSU. LSU's offense is ranked in the top 5 in adjusted rushing, passing, explosiveness, and success rate, and there is not an offense that Oklahoma has seen that is ranked nearly as high in those metrics. The closest comparison is Texas's adjusted rush offense, and it is ranked 16th, and they held Texas to 100 yards rushing, but LSU is currently ranked 5th. So other than the Sooner defense seeing their offense in practice, there is not an offense they have seen that is remotely as good as LSU during the regular season. Now, the Sooner offense has faced some similar teams that compare with LSU's defense, but it can be good news and bad news. The good news is Baylor's rush defense is a few spots ahead of LSU, and they were able to effectively run the football in the first game when they were fully healthy for 228 yards. But in the second game, they had some difficulty running the ball, but they were not at full strength. It can be noted that they missed Trey Sermon, and they will have been shuffling players on the offensive line for multiple positions. Kansas State's pass defense shows up here. But Jalen Hurts was able to throw for almost 400 yards against the Wildcats. But LSU's pass defense is a few notches ahead of K-State, and LSU has been playing a few players not at full strength all season. Now, as we review the tail of the tape, it looks like this is going to be a shootout. Both offenses has a clear advantage over the defense, and there are pushes in overall SP and F+ ratings. LSU is a heavy favorite in Vegas by 12 points, and Bill Connolly's SP+ rating has LSU with a 64% win probability as a 6-point favorite. The game will be played at Mercedes-Benz Stadium, so there will be no win factoring in for special teams, but this would more than likely be a home game for LSU since their fans don't have a long way to go from Baton Rouge. There are two things that are certain. LSU's offense is no joke, and Oklahoma's defense are not the wet paper bag they were last year. I can't lie here, but LSU has a clear advantage over the Oklahoma defense. To speak this in Dragon Ball language, Oklahoma's defense transformed from Saiyan to Super Saiyan over the last year, but LSU's offense has gone from Saiyan to Super Saiyan Blue. The transformation is just that drastic. Now, there are two concerns for both teams. The first thing is the health of running back Clyde Edwards-Helaire, who has had a sensational season. Reports are that he has suffered a hamstring injury in practice, and if he can't go, that is a vital cog in their offense, and Oklahoma will be without defensive end Ronnie Perkins, as he is currently facing a suspension, and he is their best pass rusher on a defense that is 15th in defensive adjusted sack rate, and safety Delarian Turner Yell is also out as well. Now, this is a night and day difference for Oklahoma's offense from their playoff appearance last year. Oklahoma's offense didn't have an overwhelming advantage over Alabama's defense, and they struggled in the first half moving the football against them. This year, there is a lot of crimson in their favor when they match up against LSU. The Sooners hold a top 5 ranking in 5 out of the 8 categories here, but the key deficiency is the Sooners' pass protection. Jalen Hurts has a tendency to hold onto the ball longer than he wants to, and LSU's pass rush has picked up over the last few weeks, averaging 4 sacks a game, and the defense is now getting healthier. I look for Oklahoma to test the LSU front, as the Oklahoma offensive line is second in offensive opportunity rate, which is the percentage of carries the offensive line gains at least 4 yards. And for Oklahoma, that is 60% of the time. For the keys of the game, it's quite simple. For LSU, they have to continue to start out fast. LSU has been notorious for getting out to large leads and getting into a rhythm on offense. If they jump out to a large lead on Oklahoma, this game could get ugly real quick. For Oklahoma, they have to tackle. And what I mean by that, they have to tackle in space, because they cannot allow LSU's wide receivers to break contain and turn an easy 6-yard catch into a 20-yard play. For the computer model has a score at 43-33 in favor of LSU. LSU's offense has scored 187% above what their opponents allow, and they have yielded 83% of their opponent's scoring average. Oklahoma has scored 146% above what their opponents allow, and they allow 85% of their opponent's scoring average as well. So here we go. Last year, Oklahoma came into this game with an explosive offense and a defense that wasn't any good. This year, they're coming into this game with an improved defense and an offense at times looked mortal. And I say that is because their offense last year had such a high standard that it is unfair to be that critical of them. LSU's offense is predicated on their pre-snap motion because they want the defense to tip their hand to show either man coverage or zone coverage. The health of Clyde Edwards-Helaire is critical here. Just because LSU recruited well at running back, there was a reason why Edwards-Helaire played more. He is a player that does everything well and he is dependable. Usually in a game of this long of a layoff, it will be harder for a team that likes to pass to knock some of the rust off, which is why I believe this game has the potential to be closer than the final score. I'm picking LSU in this game to win this one by double digits because I think the injuries are going to be too much for Oklahoma to overcome. Jalen Hurts will play well in this game. I just don't think it's going to be enough. I have LSU winning this game to the score of 45-31. And this is where I sign off on this game preview. Let me know what your thoughts are in the game in the comment section below. Give me your score prediction and also tell me why your respective team is going to win the game. I hope you enjoyed the video. All I ask is that you give the video a like. And if you love college football as much as I do, hit that subscribe button if you want to stay updated with the latest previews and the occasional highlights. Thank you again for watching and thank you for visiting the channel.